I realize I look like a carrot, so I will never be using this combo ever again. Hey guys, today I have a bunch of miscellaneous items from Lush, so let's get right to it. First up is Yuzu and Cocoa Shower Cream. This is super fluorescent yellow, like it looks like egg yolk. It smells a lot like, obviously, cocoa, and it smells like oranges, so like a chocolate orange. It's actually more creamy than the other shower creams, and it's a little bit thicker as well, so I really like that a lot. It's just super fluorescent. It's a little off-putting for me. This is Imogen Rose. It's a solid perfume, and I thought I would try this one out first because it is rose, and I really like the smell of Lush's rose stuff. However, this actually smells like roses, like real roses. I kind of like their fake smelling Lush rosy stuff more, but smells good. What I suggest with the solid perfumes is keep putting it on throughout the day because it doesn't last very long. But I guess the whole point of perfume isn't for you to be marinated in any type of smell, so you want that simple, subtle scent. It's not greasy and you don't feel it on your skin at all, so I actually really like this stuff a lot. This is Bohemian Soap. I really like it. I think it's kind of pretty. It's unique and it looks like it's got massive chunks in it. It's lemon. It has that really fresh lemon scent, and lemon is a natural astringent, so you will feel clean and it balances the skin's moisture. I think it really smells a lot like Pez, the lemon candy. It's pretty awesome. Makes me want to try it, but yeah, can't eat soap. Because it's lemon, I use it as a kitchen soap. This is Grease Lightning. Grease Lightning is a spot treatment used to cleanse and soften upset skin with a gentle herbal infusion of thyme, tea tree, and rosemary. A little goes a long way. It leaves your skin feeling really tight and has that aloe vera texture to it. The problem that I have with it is that when I use a spot treatment, I want it to feel like it's nuking whatever it is it's supposed to be cleaning. With this, it just feels like you're putting on goops of aloe vera and that's it. No matter how little I used, it still felt really heavy. It's not a light product at all. For me, it actually didn't do anything. If anything, it made me have more breakouts than I did before. My husband swears by it though, so I just think that my biological chemistry is not fit for it. I'm not the only one though, if you read the reviews on Lush's product page for Grease Lightning. Oh well, can't win them all. These are Dirty Toothy Tabs. Sexy spearmint breath and sparkling clean teeth will help keep it fresh in the bedroom. They've got a strong spearmint flavor. The moment you chomp down, you get a really chalky spearmint blast. They crush really easily, a lot easier than those rose toothy tabs I tried, but they don't have that really minty aftertaste. They're also not as chalky as the rose toothy tabs, but you definitely feel and taste baking soda in them. Not really a fan of the toothy tabs, but with these, it's like I'm getting there. This is Fresh Farmacy Cleanser, and I can smell it from here, and it is grossing me out. I don't know what it is, but this just does not smell good to me, and for it to be called Fresh Farmacy, I wouldn't expect it to be gross. It's a calamine-based cleansing bar, so it's supposed to be calming and reduces redness, and apparently it's Lush's most sensitive cleanser. With me, it feels like it leaves this clay-like residue, which I guess is expected because it is calamine, but it leaves that residue and I don't feel very clean afterward. So it's for sensitive skin, but I would say it's more for oily skin because it totally dried out my face. So the smell is bad. It itself doesn't really do what it says it will do. They have much better cleansers out there, but if you do have really oily skin, then definitely try this one out. Last up is Blackberry Balm. Now, Blackberry Balm is normally purple. Like, it actually is purple. I've used this balm so many times, and it's always purple. This one I got out of the pop box, and it is clearly blue. I'm confused. And I didn't notice it before until now. Still smells like Blackberry Balm, though. Blackberry is a really simple balm, but it really packs a punch on scent. I've always loved this smell, and it kind of sticks to you for quite a while. It's a fruity fragrance of bergamot with frankincense. It gives the water a faint purple haze, and it leaves a little boom boom behind. It does also leave tub residue, but that could also be from me not cleaning the tub 100% after my recent bath melt. This is definitely a cult classic. So if you're on the fence about getting crazy looking balms or anything like that, you want to start out with something subtle, this one definitely. That's all I have for you guys today. Thank you for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe because next week I have a lot of rose scented items and some sensual items as well. See you then.